And now, the testing procedure for the bone sample.
Measure the sample gauge length, which is the section that is not set in the resin, using a caliper and report the value. Then measure the sample diameter at three different positions twice by measuring the diameter of the narrowest part of the bone and the thickest part of the bone, and report the values. Now bring the bone sample mounted in the torsion adapters to the mechanical tester. To be able to insert the mounted sample in the torsion bases, position the mounted sample next to the bottom torsion base and using the manual controls, lower the vertical stage at medium speed so that it overlaps with the upper torsion adapter. Then insert the mounted sample into the torsion bases. Using the manual controls, lower the stage at low speed to approximately 2 mm above the upper torsion adapter. Now perform the following sequence: a zero load, followed by a fine contact with the stage axis as the vertical position, and a velocity of 0.01 mm per second, a contact criteria of 0.3 newton, a stage limit of 3 mm, and a stage repositioning based on the stop criteria plus an offset, with the offset being 0 mm. Now we can execute the sequence. Then secure the torsion adapters in the torsion base using the two screws for each torsion base. Then remove the alignment mount. Then manually set the position theta to 0. And now proceed with the following sequence to perform the torsion test: a zero load, followed by a move relative function with the position theta as the stage axis, an amplitude of minus 360 degrees, and a velocity of 5 degrees per second. We will save the data from the move relative function as group number underscore team number underscore torsion underscore bone. Note that a zero position function with position theta as a stage axis parameter can also be added between the zero load function and the move relative function. We can now execute the sequence. Now that the torsion test is done, using the manual controls, raise the vertical stage at medium speed and unscrew the torsion adapters from the torsion base. Using a caliper, measure the wall thickness of the cortical bone after the femur has experienced failure and report the value. Then, dispose of the sample.